Hello, devoted patrons of the performing arts. Welcome to the annual BHS Winter Concert Extravaganza. My name is Connor Hathaway, for those of you that don't know me. Should it be many? A proud member of our BHS Music Department and Choral Program. I know you're all stoked as ponies to have live music return to this auditorium, so strive for brevity with these opening remarks and reminders. Please, and I'm embarrassed that I'm still making this request after all these years, but silence your phones now! I'll wait. Next up, please discreetly and thoughtfully make any needed entrances or exits from the auditorium in between musical selections. Do not, I repeat, do not make any ill-timed appearances up or down the aisles while music is being performed by these hardworking and talented youths. It's distracting, it's awkward, and worst of all, it's uncouth. Additionally, please be mindful and respectful of all of the pandemic-related safety protocols throughout the performance. Refrain from eating and drinking in the auditorium. Please keep those masks over your mouth and nose at all times. And please, leave some empty seats between your immediate family and those around you if you're able to do so. We sincerely thank you for your compliance with all these requests. Lastly, we would like to thank some fine people without whom events like these would not be possible. Superintendent Chirotek and the Beverly School Central Office Administration, Principal Taylor and the BHS Administrative Team, our beloved booster organization, Bumpa, and the top-notch custodial staff. And most importantly, all of you for the support and love and care you provide the talented young people who are about to take the stage. Your belief in the sustaining creative power of music in the lives of these kids play a major role in why music continues to thrive in our city. And let's not forget the fine folks at Bevcam for graciously filming tonight's concert. Shout out to all of you watching live.
Bye.
Just making sure I look good. And now, without further ado, sit back, relax, as the BHS Treble Choir takes the stage under the direction of the choral director and your 2020 Essex County Virtual Pickleball Rookie of the Year, Carolyn Palenin Kudlik. Thank you.
Seats red as they dimmed out all lights. A tech
Thank you. Merrily on high, with the bells ring, Lord, hear they ding-dong-ding. Merrily on high, with the bells ring, Lord. or any alum in the house from the vocal ensemble? We always end every year with our deck of halls. Hello!
To be a part of live music's triumphant return to Beverly High School. My name is Olivia Arnberg, and though I'm the only one introducing the jazz band's first number of the evening, I am in fact just one of 20 disarmingly talented musicians in this collective, seated directly behind me. The chaotic and swinging gospel-inflected waltz you're about to hear was written and recorded by enigmatic bassist Charles Mingus in 1959, a watershed year for jazz history that also heralded the arrival of John Coltrane's Giant Steps and Miles Davis's Kind of Blue. In this raucous and unhinged tune that Mingus himself said was inspired by the atmosphere he witnessed in church, we hear all sections of the band coalesce into an exclamatory melody of joy that is anchored all the way through by a familiar vehicle in popular music, the blues. Featuring solos by Mars Ophranos, Will Kilcoyne, William Baumel, myself, Matt Lee, Olivia Thompson, Harrison Skilling, and Ebenezer Moscarello. Here now is Charles Mingus's Better Get Hit in Your Soul.
Thank you. music department, fam. How about that last number by the jazz band? Were they swinging or what? Well, now we all need to tone it down as we make it a bit of a pivot into ballad territory. My name is Reverend Connor Busick, a senior in the jazz band. While it's true that I mostly pledge my musical allegiance to the primal punk poetry of bands like Black Flag and Bad Religion, I also have a softer side that can only truly be nourished by the sort of earnest and tender jazz balladry that you're about to enjoy. Trumpeter Thad Jones wrote this lush lullaby back in 1969 as a slow and simplistic 32-bar waltz. It was immediately regarded as a jazz standard after it was recorded a year later with the Mel Lewis Orchestra, and it continues to be lauded for its simple beauty and gossamer ambience more than 50 years later. In addition to featuring sterling solos by William Kilcoy and Olivia Thompson, our performance will also be conducted by our student teacher, Lauren Sleva, who spent 8 weeks working with us earlier this fall. Please welcome Miss Sleva to the podium now for A Child is Corn, I mean Born.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Mars Lafons, a current senior and bassist for the VHS Jazz Band. Since the beginning of high school, I have collaborated with my peers to create music. During the pandemic while at home, I got the opportunity to spend more time creating a full piece. I sent the song I wrote in the winter of 2020 to 21 to Mr. Costa, and he wanted to see if we could perform part of it during the virtual spring concert of last year. From that point on, many months of feedback and revisions led to the portion of the song that was performed in June at the last Lynch Park gig. Further months of revisions led to the full arrangement. I couldn't have completed this piece without the feedback and support of Mr. Costa and the collaboration and feedback from my peers. Shout out to Will Kilcoyne for helping me improve the piece. Originally called Jazz Song, then Jazz Song 2, many versions of this continuously evolving piece have finally led to the song that you are about to hear. I am also extremely thankful for all of my fellow jazz band members who have brought this piece to life despite many adjustments. Included are powerful solos by Will Kilcoyne on piano, Connor Busick on tenor saxophone, freshman Oliver Sweatman on trombone, and Stuart Moran on alto saxophone. Beginning with a section that reminds some of a layered jungle, which transitions into the mighty and spiteful conversation of the thinking process, thinking it through, later softens into the laid-back but fast-paced Cuban-inspired jazz before returning to the beginning theme. The song embodies the process of thinking as well as an ambient compilation of conversation, but the rest is up to your interpretation. I hope you enjoy thinking it through.
Thank you. I'll discover goes much deeper than the cover. And I'm about to show what I can do. Take away.
Garden City music fans. My name is Evan Michael Moscarello, or as they call me at this time of year, Ebenezer Scrooge. In addition to serving as your dutiful MC for this first number on the program tonight by the BHS Concert Band, I am also a fan of drums, dogs, fancy words like vespertine and cruciverbalist, and making the occasional dad joke. Though not obvious, this nearly 7-minute work by famed American composer Howard Hanson, originally composed in 1918, begins something of a pandemic theme with our repertoire this evening. This composition was originally scheduled to be performed by the band for our 2020 spring concert, but as our descent into quarantining madness and virtual learning got underway, work had to be suspended with less than half of the piece fully learned by our students. Now here we are, 21 months later, and we've decided to tie up loose ends. Both a symbolic gesture of coming full circle, and also a nod to the festive and pulchritudinous music one naturally encounters during the holiday season, here is Howard Hanson's triumphal ode.
Hello, everyone. My name is Harrison Skillen, a senior member of the saxophone section, and an all-around good guy, or so I've been told. I'm also an Eagle Scout who can tie approximately 627 knots more efficiently than you can tie your shoes. Also, can you believe I actually put my name into this lottery to be selected to read one of these long-winded introductions? I know, me either. In all truthfulness, though, it is my sincerest pleasure to introduce your next work of the program, which is a lyrical composition by female Canadian composer Kate Nishimura. Like most of her body of work, the piece we are playing tonight by this young Toronto composer is very much inspired by nature and the outdoors. Originally written for SATB Choir in 2017, it was arranged for concert band a year later, and then edited once again this past year in response to the shifting demands of instrumental musical programs in the wake of COVID. The result you'll hear tonight retains the original four-part writing of the version written for the choir. The accompanying lyrics includes these evocative words. Memories swirl in these cool breeze, through warmth lingers in the arms of trees, holding on until the last single leaf falls. Here now is Autumn Leaves by Kate Nishimura.